Are Rihanna and Kendall Jenner still feuding? There are a lot of celebrities out there who don't like to associate themselves with the Kar-Jenner clan, but Rihanna is one of the rare ones who've been very outspoken about just how much she can't stand the family, and especially Kendall Jenner. It's also interesting that Kendall never actually shaded Rihanna, at least not publicly, and yet Riri dissed Kendall more than once and still hates her to this day. So what's Rihanna's problem with Kendall? Before we get into it, make sure you hit that subscribe button for more exclusive content about your favorite celebs. In case you're wondering why there are literally zero pictures of Rihanna and Kendall Jenner together, well, it's because Rihanna apparently can't stand Kendall and the Kardashian-Jenner family. It all started way back in 2012, when Kendall took to Twitter to share her excitement about seeing Rihanna perform her favorite song live in concert. "If Rihanna doesn't perform Complicated tomorrow, I'm gonna get very upset," Kendall tweeted. Kendall, who was 16 at the time, was most likely just joking around and fangirling over Rihanna. However, Rihanna obviously thought differently, because her clapback was way more savage than anyone expected. "Well, don't come," Rihanna snapped. At the time, a lot of fans slammed Rihanna for being unnecessarily rude, and they called her out for going after a teenager. One fan commented, "Why would she tell Kendall to not come when she was clearly so excited to see her? This is so mean. Like, why didn't she think of Kendall as a fan who loves her?" However, others jumped to Rihanna's defense and said, "The Kardashians Jenners think that the world revolves around them, and Riri simply wanted to let them know that it doesn't." Then, of course, there's the whole fashion icon issue, and many of Rihanna's fans think Kendall and her sisters are nothing but copycats who take credit for other people's ideas, especially Rihanna, while Rihanna is a true original. Sure, there's no denying that Kendall is a very successful model who's walked the runways for some of the biggest names in the industry. However, Kendall's overnight success, her disrespectful comments about other models, and her awkward runway walk have drawn a lot of backlash from fans who are convinced Kendall pretty much got her modeling career handed to her. And yes, it seems like Rihanna feels the same way. In 2015, Rihanna actually pulled out of the Victoria's Secret fashion show after her friend and British model Jordan Dunn got replaced by Kendall. Jordan Dunn later took to Twitter to slam Victoria's Secret and called the show BS. "Feeling so much better about not doing BS. Sorry, I mean VS, now that Rihanna isn't doing it also," Jordan tweeted. And although sources close to Rihanna claimed at the time that Riri canceled her Victoria's Secret appearance because she was working on her 8th studio album, Anti, the fans were convinced her decision had something to do with Jordan getting replaced by Kendall last minute. So glad that Rihanna is supporting Jordan Dunn. "Honestly, complete BS that they replaced her with Kendall, who has never worked with VS," one fan commented. Kendall later drew even more backlash when she just respected other models in her August 2018 interview with Love Magazine, in which she was quoted saying, "Since the beginning, we've been super selective about what shows I would do. I was never one of those girls who would do like 30 shows a season or whatever those girls do." And don't forget that Kendall had been previously named the highest paid model in the world by Forbes magazine, leaving behind catwalk veterans like the likes of Gisele Bündchen and Adriana Lima. Of course, the fans thought that the whole thing was a joke and claimed the only reason Kendall booked so many shows is because of her social media reach and her famous family. Kendall Jenner gives us absolutely nothing in every campaign, runway, cover story, and editorial, one fan commented. "If it wasn't for her family's fame, she wouldn't have been the highest paid supermodel. I can name so many models who actually have a passion for this and deserve recognition." To top it all off, the same year Kendall was named the highest earning model in the world, she also received the Fashion Icon of the Decade Award. And while no one's denying that Kendall has served some iconic looks in the past, naming her the Fashion Icon of the Decade was definitely a reach. The fans were quick to point out how, if anyone deserved to be called the fashion icon of the decade, it was Rihanna, especially considering that Kendall was just 21 when she got the award, so they were basically implying that she's been killing the fashion game since she was 11. How? "Imagine thinking Kendall is the fashion icon of this decade when Rihanna exists," one fan commented at the time. Another person added, "We all know why Kendall will get the fashion icon award instead of Rihanna, and it's not because of her style." And although Rihanna didn't comment on Kendall's Fashion of the Icon title at the time, her silence spoke more than words could. Still, this is Rihanna we're talking about, and you already know that she doesn't hold back when it comes to speaking her mind, so it didn't take long before Kendall found herself at the receiving end of Rihanna's sharp tongue. Rihanna threw some major shade at Kendall during the 2018 Met Gala and made fun of her slender figure. One insider told Star that Rihanna was standing next to Kendall Jenner at the bar and loudly said, "Good thing I have curves to pull this outfit off. I would hate to be a stick figure." Then she just stared at Kendall, laughed in her face, and walked away, the source added. Well, no matter how Rihanna feels about Kendall, body shaming is never okay, and the fans were quick to call out Riri for taking shots at Kendall over her figure. One fan commented, "I really don't hate Rihanna, but sometimes she thinks being rude is a personality trait." However, some of Riri's fans clapped back and said Kendall is not so innocent herself. "I heard Kendall isn't the nicest either, so maybe it's karma coming full circle," one fan commented. Not only did these fans blast Kendall for missing the theme of the Met Gala and wearing what was probably the most underwhelming outfit of the night, but they also pointed out how nobody should feel sorry for Kendall because she's done a lot of problematic things in the past, including betraying Selena Gomez. Unlike Rihanna, who always comes through with iconic looks for every Met Gala, both Kendall and Kylie looked like they didn't even bother to read the dress code and just showed up for publicity. One Twitter user wrote, "Who allowed Kendall Jenner into the Met Gala looking like that? Better yet, who allowed those who don't follow the Met's dress code into the event at all? If y'all can't show up and show out, you gotta go." Many fans also brought up the whole Kendall and Selena situation, and one of them commented, "Good for Rihanna. Kendall hurt Selena and didn't care. She's a cold person." Another fan added, "Literally, Jenners and Kardashians have such an attitude, it hurts. I'm so glad Rihanna did that. Selena and Rihanna are literally so unproblematic. As for Rihanna, she may be many things, but she doesn't come across as a fake person. And as far as we know, she's never stabbed any of her friends in the back the way Kendall did to Selena." According to one insider close to Selena, after Kendall was caught hanging out with Justin Bieber back in 2015 behind Selena's back, Selena said that she felt betrayed and stabbed in the back by Kendall. Not only did Kendall backstab Selena, she also lied to many of her mutual friends that Justin never loved Selena. Many fans said that they didn't care whether Rihanna really threw shade at Kendall's figure at the Met Gala, because Kendall allegedly has a reputation for being rude and arrogant when the cameras are off. One fan commented, "I stumbled upon some videos of fans meeting Kendall Jenner, and she seems to be such a rude and arrogant person when no cameras are around." Oh, and remember when Julia Carolyn, a former hostess for Nobu in downtown Manhattan, exposed Kendall on TikTok?
So next up we have Kendall Jenner. This is another one where I unfortunately did not have the best experience with them. She used to come in all the time and was pretty cold towards staff. She also usually has someone speak for her and doesn't speak directly to staff. I'm gonna give her the benefit of the doubt and say she's just shy. From my experiences with her, I have to give her like a 4 out of 10.
The fans said that they were not surprised to hear this about Kendall, and one of them commented on Julia's video, "Ain't even surprised about the Jenners, especially Kendall. Few people have constantly said she has an attitude problem." Another person added, "Literally, Hailey Bieber and Kendall always get the worst reviews when people meet them. I haven't heard one person that has met either of them and got good vibes. I can feel their bad vibes through the screen." But is this really why Rihanna can't stand Kendall? I mean, there are plenty of other celebs out there who are known for their rude and stuck-up behavior, and yet Rihanna never threw shade at them. So why Kendall? Well, many fans seem to think that although Kendall has probably never been rude to Rihanna, the reason Rihanna can't stand Kendall and her family is the same reason millions of other people around the world don't like the Kardashian Jenners. Basically, there are a lot of people out there who think Kendall is a culture vulture who only got to where she is thanks to her family connections. Unlike Kendall, Rihanna came from a humble background and worked very hard for everything she has. Take for example this TikTok video of a fan breaking down why Kendall's latest business venture, her own tequila brand, is a prime example of white privilege, nepotism, and cultural appropriation.
So yesterday I posted this video about Kendall's new tequila brand. And a lot of Mexican people are upset and they're calling this cultural appropriation because Kendall is calling this the best tequila, it's authentic, and it's grown in Jalisco. And a lot of Mexican people are like, what the hell does Kendall Jenner know about growing agave in Jalisco and making tequila? And to add insult to injury, Kendall posted a video of her sampling her tequila, but it had ice cubes in it. And anybody who drinks tequila knows you do not drink tequila with ice. And then there were alcohol experts defending Kendall, saying, actually, if you put some ice cubes in tequila, it helps it water down and the flavors come through. Not white Americans telling Mexicans how they should be drinking their tequila. So obviously Kendall's getting a lot of heat due to her family's history with cultural appropriation. And in this case, it's granted, because what does Kendall Jenner actually know about the art, culture, and history of tequila making in Mexico? She just paid a Mexican company to do all the work, then she just slapped on her label and gets all the credit. For everyone saying, well, yeah, that's capitalism. That's the problem. POC do all the work and white people get all the credit.
So when you add all of these things up, it really isn't that much of a surprise Rihanna doesn't associate herself with Kendall or the Kardashians. After all, they really don't have anything in common, and it's hard to even imagine what Rihanna and Kendall's conversations will look like. Still, some of Kendall's fans think there's no reason for Rihanna to publicly throw shade at Kendall, especially that time when Kendall was just 16. So now we want to know how you feel about Rihanna's attitude towards Kendall. Do you think Rihanna was being rude to her for no reason? Or do you appreciate how blunt Rihanna is? Let us know in the comment section down below.